Hi, and welcome back to The Shtick, where we have with us storyteller, author, social activist, award-winning person of distinction, Mr. Arnold Zable.
Thank you. Great to be here, Henry.
You're almost getting a knighthood here. Is it an OAAO? Adults only. We're going to talk about Cafe Scheherazade, which was your second novel.
It was a novel. Well, Jewels and Ashes is actually a memoir. Cafe Scheherazade, was a novel, and it tried to encapsulate that extraordinary place, Scheherazade on Ackland Street, which brought together actually refugees, Jewish refugees, and then later on became an iconic place for people in general who were interested in European cuisine and that atmosphere, that cultured atmosphere they created there. It tells the stories of the stories that are told there.
Exactly.
And, you know, Scheherazade was a storyteller. She told stories for 1,001 nights, and here's a place where it would take at least 1,001 nights to hear all the stories that are told there. But the basic story is of running.
Escaping.
People who went from one place to the next. And I was very keen to tell the stories of those that went east, as well as those that went through the Holocaust, those that escaped via Russia, and some came to Shanghai and to Japan, and so it was a wonderful, wonderful project to engage in, and to find a way to encapsulate the stories that are told there.
The other one I wanted to mention, the next novel, was The Fig Tree.
Well, The Fig Tree is a collection of stories, and really that is dedicated to my son,
who Alexander,
he didn't know his four grandparents. One was lived until he was a year old, and it begins with Alexander on my shoulder as a two-year-old, and then it moves from there through stories about his grandparents. My father was a Yiddish poet, my mother a singer of Yiddish song before the war, and then of course had to just get down to it, work in factories, Victoria Market, to make a new life. And I move through these stories, and then it breaks out to a wider exploration of Jewish and Greek cultures, and the stories that have been so much a part of my life. And ends up actually with a story about Melech Ravitch, the great Yiddish writer who went out to the outback and explored indigenous people's lives back in the 1930s.
Was that related to Yossel Bergner?
Yeah, Melech Ravitch was Yossel Bergner's father.
Right, okay.
So that's The Fig Tree, and then came Scraps of Heaven, which is a novel that's set in Carlton, where I try to recreate 1 year in the life of Shtetl Carlton. So it's set in 1958. The character Josh is partly based on me, and Romek and Sophia are partly based on my parents. And I was determined to paint a picture not only of the Jewish world, but of the working class Aussies that lived in the same street, in the same neighborhood, the truckie that lived a couple of doors away.
And talking about painting a picture, you've got two brothers, Benny and Harry, who I've known for many years, and they are both artists, which is, it's inherited in your family to be creative and artistic.
I think so, and you know, if I have to define, one of my definitions of the way I work is painting with words. I think that's or it's the art of scene construction, constructing the scenes so that people are actually there. They're back in the back lanes.
Through words.
Well, they're back in the back lanes of Carlton, and they're back in the Curtin Square, and they're back in Canning Street, they're back in the Kadimah, they're back in Lygon Street. So it has to be seen. It has to be seen. So you're painting those scenes, and that's the craft. You know, You practice the craft, and you acquire the craft as you work at it.
You told me that your brothers and you created a Marx Brothers scenario.
Well, there was a time when we flirted with the possibility. I used to do piano duets with my brother Ben. We used to, it was a party trick where we'd play the hits of the time, hit tunes of the time.
Well, I remember Benny being an activist. He was the first anti-nuclear activist in Australia.
No. There was a long tradition.
He was the first.
Henry, there was a long tradition in Australia of
before
activism.
Benny.
Oh yeah, look, Australia. One of the Australia's got a wonderful history of activism, and a lot of it came through the labour movement.
Mm.
And we don't know enough history.
I'm talking about my recollection. I don't know about all the other things that happened, but I remember seeing him on a bunch of 44-gallon drums painted with the nuclear signs, and he's got this amazing outfit on. He looks like something out of a horror movie.
Ben is a fantastic artist.
Yes.
You know, he practiced art for many years, and he's got fantastic paintings, Chagall-like paintings of Carlton, dancing houses. And
yes, I know. I went to his exhibition he had in Punt Road.
Yeah, that used to be the gallery.
That's right. And Harry took up art in a later date. He didn't even know he was an artist.
Yeah, well, he started his watercolours when he settled in Castlemaine. Yeah.
Yes, and I've been following him on Facebook, and his work is just amazing. He's like the old masters, the Australian early painters that painted landscapes. So the other book I wanted to just to touch on is Sea of Many Returns. What was that about?
That's a novel that's entirely set on the island of Ithaca, where I've spent a lot of time over the years. As Alexander was growing up with my wife Dora, we'd go there and stay in the village for months on end. So her ancestors, her folks come from the island. It's been a big part of my life, and I wanted to capture the stories I heard both at Ithacan gatherings here in Melbourne and also back on the island. But I focus on the journeys of Greek immigrants who made their way to all corners of the world. It's all based on the wonderful, wonderful stories I heard from the old sailors and seamen and the people that's sitting in the cafes on the island, walking the paths of the island, and actually experiencing island life, actually going through the olive picking season and working in the vineyards and the olive groves. So it's a testament to that part of my life.
In relation to Yiddish culture, I just wanted to touch on this because it's so important in my life and your life, because Yiddish is my mamalushin, which is my mother tongue, and it's also yours. Did you speak Yiddish at home?
Oh yeah, I mean Yiddish is mamalushin, and I weave. This is another thing that is important to my work, is weaving in language. So in the Greek novel, for example, I bring in Greek where I can, because I think it's part of where Australian literature is going and beginning to, in Australian literature, we're starting to see language, Aboriginal languages coming in and languages from many parts of the world that sort of thread their way through the stories. And I think that's very important. This is how cultures grow and become diverse and rich. And so in the stories that are Jewish based, I bring in language and weave it into the fabric of the novel or the story. But yeah, look, Yiddish, every language is another way of being. That's what it is. One of the most wonderful events that I've ever participated in was reading my work. I actually read from Sea of Many Returns in Simpson's Gap out at near Alice Springs at a Northern Territory Writers Festival, reading it as the sun was setting, and then under the night sky, sitting with Aboriginal writers, especially women actually, around lanterns, and they read their works in language, and you could hear the oceans, you could hear the desert sands, you could hear the winds. It's actually in the language itself. And so, yeah, language is, that's the basic tools of the trade, is language.
It's like a tam, a Yiddish tam.
Well, it has, each one has its own tam.
Yeah,
each correct. Language has its own.
But for us, it's Yiddish tam.
Yeah, yeah.
Anyway, we're going to come back in the next segment with you talking about your social activism.
Okay.
Because I think it's very important to talk about things like asylum seekers, justice for people who are being locked up. And wonder why they're doing that.
Okay.
We'll be back after the break with more of Arnold Zable.